Which camera should you use to start a YouTube channel this year? This channel has been up for 12 months now, my channel a little bit longer, and we have made so many mistakes.
Go f*** yourself.
I don't know how to be funny.
We've fallen into so many pitfalls with cameras and devices.
We burned so much cash, didn't we?
Jens thinks it's user error. You do realize that what you've just said, nobody can hear.
Please don't do that. We bought so many cameras we don't actually need. Now we have a huge setup, but we think we are now qualified because we did all the mistakes to give you kind of some sort of advice and give you an overview of what we are using.
Why do I always fall down?
And if you're new to our channel, my name is Jens. I was born and bred in Berlin, in Germany, and I'm married to
Tony, and I'm from Sheffield, Yorkshire, in the UK.
The best thing to start with is to differentiate the situations, isn't it? We have an indoor setup, which is like kind of a stationary setup, if you like. We go outside and then it's an outside run and gun setup where we shoot B-roll, where we shoot different style of our product shots, but also sometimes we vlog. And there are three different situations, and we have, as we said at the beginning, three different cameras for that because we spend too much money on that. But let's start with the stationary setup, right? We have the Sony a6400 right here. This is what we're shooting with when we're inside, and it's got the Sigma 1.4 aperture 16mm lens on there. And that is a stationary setup, right? And then we have an external microphone and a flip-up screen, as you know. And the stationary setup here is, we've chosen the Sony a6400 because it gives us that 4K crisp image picture. And this is really, Sony's known for that picture quality in 4K, right? It's an unlimited recording we have, and so many more things in this camera we appreciate, but we don't want to take it outside for one reason, well, maybe two reasons, and that is the image in-body stabilization that is just not there. But also the biggest hold up for us is the menu system.
It could be said that we bought this camera as an all-rounder.
Yes, you can certainly use it for every situation because it got not just 4K footage. It kind of skips HD because HD is not great on that camera, but you have a full HD slow motion, high frame rate. You have a 4K time lapse, and all of this is built in. And with this one lens, it gives you that really indoor crisp footage, if you like. But the menu system and kind of ergonomics, but we could get over that, but the menu system is really what holds us back here. Right?
So what we found after we bought it as an all-rounder is that it is better placed indoors in the studio setup, and we never move it. So then we have an overhead setup, which is for our product shots or my card shots, and that is the Sony A7 R3.
And we're using a G Master lens, the 16-35mm 2.8 aperture. And the reason why we use the Sony A7 R3, number one, is we bought it and we can't get rid of it anymore. But number two is the best usage for that is it has the crop mode. What does it mean? It crops into the picture. And the crop mode is actually a better quality for the picture. It's a 5K picture quality when you crop in. That is really interesting or really needed sometimes when you have these detailed product shots. When I go up here, then you have a better picture quality than any other camera we have. And that's pretty cool. And that's one of the main reasons why we use it as an overhead camera.
So the next section for me is my favorite section, the outdoor section, the bad boy section. It is our outdoor run and gun camera, and it is the Canon EOS R.
Yes.
That piece of cake should never have happened today.
And we bought this camera when everybody was hating on it, right? The full YouTube community was 90%, oh my God, this camera, why did you do that, Canon? And we said, well, we actually like it. It's some age, you just go against a trend. And then we bought the Canon EOS R, and we are super happy with that. And there's several reasons for that, because we are beginners, right? So we appreciate an easy menu system.
We appreciate getting it out of the box and being able to use it on day one.
That's what we did. And we learned a lot about this camera, and we really can, I can happily say that this is the main lens, that is the 24mm 1.4 Canon lens. And there is so many things we really appreciate about this camera. Number one is the menu system. Number two, the obvious is the flippy screen. And people tell you maybe it's not that important. And we thought it's not that important. Even with the Sony a6400, it has a flip up screen. This has a every angle tilt screen, and it makes it so much easier to go outside and shoot. Number three is the ND filter. We do like the ND filter here with the EF adapter, right? So you can just adjust that to any settings you want. And that's pretty cool. And that's kind of a ease of use. But the main reason, not just kind of overall package, but the main reason why we really stick with this camera is the picture quality out of the box when you use it is absolutely superb, right? It has this 4K crop, and we do try to shoot a lot of our footage in 4K, and we have to adjust to that.
I would actually say that if you are anything like me and are a little bit camera shy or do not want to use cameras, I do not like using or learning menu systems at all.
No.
The Canon EOS R is absolutely perfect for you. I would also say on top of that, that out of all the cameras that we have, there is only one that has an emotional reaction for me,
yeah.
And that is the Canon EOS R.
Important to mention that this is full frame. This is obviously more expensive than the Sony a6400. The Sony a6400 is an APS-C sensor, smaller sensor. Different use cases. There's also the C-Log. We do try to shoot something in C-Log sometimes to give that really punchy color feeling. And if you look at some of our product shots, then I am actually surprised what comes out of it. I think it's me, but it's probably the camera, right? So
it makes us look good.
Yeah.
And the next section is the vlogging section. You will see from our videos that we do not do a great deal of vlogging, but when we do, I can't take my hands off because I am ridiculously unstable on a bike. We have the
DJI Osmo Action, and we tried this one over the GoPro Hero 7. We didn't try the GoPro Hero 8. That's a different
not
story.
Yet.
But the audio is better. Picture quality is probably, well, it's similar, but we're not big on vloggers. But if you look at some of our footage, we just hold it up and talk into it. And then it's fine. It does us good, right?
It does the job.
Yeah, we also tried the M50 for vlogging and other stuff. And although it is good and it's got that flip-out screen, this is just much easier. Also, what I said at the beginning, the GoPro Hero 8 is, just came out, but also has these media mods. Nobody has tried them yet. That means you have a little microphone on the side, you have a little flippy screen, and
he's talked about it all morning, and we need to get one.
So that may be something you should look into when it comes out. Obviously, you can use your phone if you want, right?
Yeah.
Also, but this is what we use. Okay, so this is our setup, but please do not forget, story is king overall. And sometimes it really doesn't matter the picture quality, and there's two scenarios you have to look at. The camera, if you use a camera and you have a setup, the setup or your story can adjust to the camera. But if you have a story that cannot adjust to the camera, it doesn't matter what you use because the story won't repeat itself.
Well, that was really uncalled for, wasn't it?
Whether that be something you see outside, you have a run and gun, just shoot whatever you have available in your pocket, right? Our recommendation is to make sure you get a camera that is future-proof. Get a camera that has superb autofocus. 6400, the Canon, they all have superb autofocus. And get a camera that is some kind of future proof, because when you start your channel now, and that's what we found ourselves in, that in 6 months time, YouTube evolved and you evolved and you want to try more, get something that you basically don't end up in crossroads and you have to choose a new camera. Get something that is future proof, that can do things that you don't want to do right now, but I can guarantee you that's something you want to do in 6 months time.
And don't forget to comment below what your YouTube channel is or what your upcoming YouTube channel will be.
We would love to check it out.
We would love to check it out. And also check out our first video.
Make sure you like and subscribe. Jensi from Alterspace.
Tony the Car Geek.
Peace out.